Good morning, students. Computer network. Now let me see the recap of previous lecture. You know what is a network? So a network is a set of devices connected with a server. Okay. Then physical structure. There are two types of physical structures available. One is a point-to-point, and another one is a multi-point. Then topology. There are four types of topology available: mesh topology, star topology, bus topology, and ring topology. Apart from that, the combination of topology, that is the hybrid topology. Now in this class, I am going to discuss the network models, various network models. The first one is a local area network. Then that is called the LAN. Wide area network, WAN, and a metropolitan area network, MAN. Now first we see what is local area network. Okay, so this is the local area network. Here we connect the systems with an hub. Okay, so in local area network, the LAN links the devices in a single office, building, or a campus. Okay, for example, to take our computer lab. So we have three labs. Okay, so assume that this is the first lab, and this one is the second lab, and this one is the third lab. Okay, so all these systems are connected, that is interlinked, by an hub. Okay, like that, within a campus, a college campus, all the systems are interconnected. That is also done by the local area network. That is, LAN can be simple as just two PC and a printer in an office. If you have two PC and a printer, then it is called a LAN, local area network. At present, the LAN size is limited to a few kilometers. Okay, when we connect the cable through 2 or 3 kilometers, or within a range of 5 kilometers, then a LAN can be formed. So the LAN is designed to allow the resources to shared between personal computer or workstations. The resources may be computer, software, hardware, printer, etc. So most common topology used in the LAN is, you can use the bus topology, or you can use the star topology, or ring topology, or even hybrid topology can also be used in LAN. Okay. The speed of LAN yearly is 4 to 16 Mbps previously. But today, the speeds are normally 100 to 1000 Mbps. Okay, that depends upon the service provider and the hardware facility. So what is called a local area network? Okay, therefore, the systems are connected by means of a hub. Suppose that if one system wants to communicate with the other system by using the hub, that is the star topology. Here you see it is a star topology. Our lab also connected by an hub, that is the star topology. Then wide area network, WAN. So local area network means it is a short distance. Okay, So wide area, it provides the long distance transmission of data, image, audio, video between the states or the countries. Okay, you see that there are two types of band is available. One is a point to point band. So under point to point band, we have connected a computer through a modem to a dedicated line to the internet service provider by means of a modem. So this is a point to point band. Then another one is a switched band. Under switched band, so these are the switches connected placed on various places. Okay, sometimes these are also called the routers. The routers are routers. So suppose here one end system A, another end system B, and another end system C. Suppose end system A send the message to end system B. Okay, the message can be broken into smaller packets, and then the packets are traveled on various routers. Okay, some packet may travels from this router, this router, this router, and then this router, and finally arrives the end state system. Some packets are arrived from this, like that. Some packets are travels from this to this, and then arrives the end system. Okay, so this is called a WAN. Okay, so a WAN can be complex that connect internet or a simple dial-up connection to a home computer to the internet. I already told you there are two types of WAN. One is a point to point WAN and another one is a switched WAN. Okay, now the next one is a MAN, Metropolitan Area Network. So the metropolitan area, that means a city, a town. Okay, so it is a network between LAN and WAN. It covers within a city or a town. It is designed that high speed connectivity for the customer normally to the internet. That means for example, we use the telephone network which provides DSL lines to the customer, that is digital subscriber line to its customer. Then another example is a cable TV network. Okay, so within the city we have connected by means of the cable TV. Okay, so these are the three types of models, that is local area network, then wide area network, and then cable TV network. Then next one is let us see inter network. So this is one simple example of the inter network. So here the president may be somewhere else, that is suppose that he may be on North India, assume that. Okay, his office is located on two different places. One may be in Tamil Nadu and another may be on northeast kind of states. Okay, so the president is at assume that Delhi. He want to connect with the office, okay, by means of internet. Okay, therefore he has a system, then modem, a point-to-point WAN connected. Then again a switched WAN. There are various routers so that the message can be transmitted. And then one office consists of the LAN with the topology, bus topology, and another office uses the LAN with the star topology. Okay, so the data are transmitted various routers like the various routers. So this is called the inter network. Then so if we look at the history, in mid 1960s, the mainframe computer in research organizations were standalone devices. That is the single user systems. Computers from different manufacturers were unable to communicate with one another. Then the Advanced Research Project Agency, that is called the ARPA, in the Department of Defense, was interested in finding a way to connect computers so that the researchers they funded could share their findings, thereby reducing the cost and eliminating duplicate of the efforts. Okay, so that in 1967, the Association of Computing Machinery meeting, that is ACM, the ARPA, that is the Advanced Research Project Agency, presented the idea of ARPANET, that is a small network of connected computer. The idea that each host computer could be attached to a specialized computer called Interface Message Processor, that is the IMP. The IMP in turn could be connected to one another. Each IMP had to be able to communicate with the other IMPs as well as its own attached host. By 1969, ARPANET was a reality. Four nodes at University of California at Los Angeles, then University of California in Santa Barbara, Stanford Research Institute, and the University of Utah were connected via IMPs to form a network. The software called the Network Control Protocol, NCP, provides communication between the host. In 1972, the ARPANET network group collaborated called Internetting Project with Vannit Cerf and Bob Hahn. And they presented a paper outlined the protocol to achieve end-to-end delivery of packets. This paper on the transmission control protocol included the concept such as encapsulation, the datagram, and the functions of the gateway. Then the TCP becomes two protocols, that is TCP BOP IP, Transmission Control Protocol, and Internet Protocol. The IP would handle the datagram, that is the packets routing, while the TCP would be responsible for higher level functions such as segmentation, reassembly, and error detection. The Internet Protocol becomes well known as TCP BOP IP, that is the Transmission Control Protocol, the Internet Protocol. Okay, let me see. So this is the today's internet. Okay, so we have ISP. ISP means Internet Service Provider. So this is the national ISP, and this one is the international ISP. So under national ISP, various regional, that is the ISPs are connected with the regional ISPs, and then the regional ISPs are connected to the national ISPs. Similarly, the international, the national, various national ISPs are connected with the NAP, that is network access point. So this is the today's internet. Okay. Thank you, students. Let me see in the next class.